eleyi ni mo sun isu kekere kan bayi je nigba ti mo si je tan mo ki koko mi bo enu mo sa ina si oru efin tu oko mi si bale daada.
My work is in many ways a fag noir narrative transmuted in real time, bristling with numerous parallelisms, but as I pored through its pages, it was to fag noir's works that my mind constantly reverted without any effort.
I heard fag noir first on the red diffusion box in our neighborhood, you know, and I was glued to the box.
I'm mesmerized by the force of the language, by the rhythm of the words, the metaphors, the proverbs. In fact, you forget the main story.
There has never been another person who played with Yoruba language in the manner that he did.
It's a fusion of, yes, Christian ideals, which I think are also Yoruba ideals, and motifs and ideas from the cosmology of the Yoruba.
The Fagunwa novels are based on the spirit of Omoluabi. That's what the Yoruba man is supposed to be. You must work, you must benefit your society, you must benefit your people, you must be a communal person, you must learn, you must be educated, you must be trained.
There is so much of what is real in the fiction of Fagunwa that has made life become a fiction in our contemporary society.
Look, the effect it had on me when I was very young, it just catapulted my imagination. I will never forget the inspiration I had for the first movement of The Eye of the Earth. It's called Forest Echoes. When you are Yoruba and you talk about forest, I mean, no way we trace you back to Fagunwa.
Ibi ti mo ti mu ikoko yi ti mo gbadun ara mi ni mo ti gba ti enikan kun la pa ibi ti igi awusa kan bayi wa.
The quality and the deployment of the language in those novels, the lessons that they teach, the audiences that they've impacted upon, the influence he has exerted on other writers, Fagunwa's works remain monumental and almost incomparable.
Aranti baba wa Daniel Olorunfemi di o Fagunwa nla npere un ogunagbogbo ti da to lenu mi onkowe itan ta le gbagbe ninu ranti wa.